A very good afternoon to all of you. This is Abhilasha Nahata, your social science teacher. So class, today we all are going to continue our chapter number 5 of your political science textbook. The name of your chapter is Judiciary. Okay. And in our previous class, we discussed about the judiciary. We have gone through the introduction of judiciary, and after that we discussed two functions of the judiciary. First function, first role of judiciary is dispute resolution. It resolves issues between citizens, between government, two state governments, between center and state governments. And second role, second important function is judicial review. According to this function, judiciary can interpret the law. Okay. So now third function of judiciary is upholding the law and enforcing fundamental rights. So as you all know, we have six fundamental rights: right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, and right to constitutional remedies. These are the six fundamental rights. Okay. So now every citizen of India can approach the Supreme Court or the High Court if they believe that their fundamental rights have been violated. So we have a basic structure. If we look at the judicial system, it looks like a pyramid system. At the apex level or at the top level, we have Supreme Court. This is Supreme Court. Okay. At the middle level, we have High Court at the state levels. And at the lowest level, we have local district courts or subordinate courts. Okay. And both High Court and district court work under the guidance of Supreme Court. Okay. Supreme Court is established in Delhi. High courts, each state has one High Court, and district courts, according to the district, they have one district court. Okay. So now, according to this function, this is the function of judiciary. If any of your fundamental rights, got violated, you have this right, according to this right, right to constitutional remedies, you can approach to the Supreme Court or High Court directly. Otherwise, what happened? अगर कोई ब्रदर्स के बीच में डिस्प्यूट हुआ है, ठीक है, सपोज देयर इज अ प्रॉपर्टी डिस्प्यूट बिटवीन टू ब्रदर्स, दे कैन दे हैव टू अप्रोच टू द डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोर्ट फर्स्ट. ओके. बट इन केस ऑफ वायलेशन ऑफ फंडामेंटल राइट्स, यू ऑल आर सपोज टू यू कैन डायरेक्टली अप्रोच टू द सुप्रीम कोर्ट और हाई कोर्ट. ओके. यू हैव दिस राइट if your fundamental right got violated. So there is an example which we already done in our previous class, in class 7, Hakim Sheikh. Okay, we talked about Hakim Sheikh. He was an agricultural laborer, and he fell from running train and injured himself, and whose condition got worse because several hospitals refused to admit him. Okay, so Hakim Sheikh, in the year 1992, Hakim Sheikh, he was the member of Pashchim Banga Khet Mazdoor Samiti. Okay, and he was an agricultural laborer, and while traveling, he fell from a running train and injured badly. Okay, and his condition got worse and worse. Okay. He moved to different government hospitals. In the first government hospital, he went there, but they refused to admit him. Why? Because of the lack of bed. After that, he moved to the second government hospital. Even in that hospital too, he got refused to admit. Why? Because of the unavailability of doctor. So aise karte karte he moved to eight different government hospitals, and they all refused to admit him. So finally he moved to the private hospitals, and he have to pay hefty charges. ठीक है, बहुत ज्यादा हेफ्टी चार्जेस उसको पे करने पड़े अपने ट्रीटमेंट के लिए. ओके. सो नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड ऑन हियरिंग दिस केस, filed the case. Okay, and on hearing this court case, the Supreme Court ruled that Article 21, which provides every citizen the fundamental right to life, also includes the right to health. It therefore directed the West Bengal government to pay him compensation for the loss suffered, as well as to come up with a blueprint for primary health care with particular reference to treatment of patients during an emergency. Okay, so according to Article 21, we have six fundamental rights, and under right to freedom, we have this right to life, and right to life also includes right to health. If we do not have like healthy lifestyle, how we get this like healthy life? Right, so under this right to life, we have right to health, and according to this fundamental right, West Bengal government, Supreme Court directed West Bengal government to pay him compensation, pay Hakim Sheikh compensation. What do you mean by compensation? Compensation means money paid. In context of this chapter, we are basically like, I'm telling you the meaning of compensation in context of this chapter. Compensation means money given to make amends for an injury or a loss. ठीक है, ऐसा कोई loss हुआ है, कोई injury हुआ है, और उसके उस पे अगर आपको compensation, कोई money जो देना होता है, ठीक है, उसको हम compensation बोलते हैं. भी like call that term compensation. Okay, so according to this here we see Hakim Sheikh got, Hakim Sheikh's fundamental rights got violated, and according to this, Supreme Court has directed West Bengal government to pay him compensation. Even they suggested, suggested, or you can say they ordered, suggested is not the right term, they ordered primary health care services ki aap ek blueprint banaiye, and according to this blueprint you all are supposed to like aapko ye cheez batani hai ki ek jo patients hain emergency situations mein jo patients aayega unko aayenge unke liye aap kya karenge kaise karenge. ठीक है, क्या क्या आपके पास अवेलेबिलिटीज होनी चाहिए. ठीक है, आपको जो सारे जितनी भी फैसिलिटीज है वो आपको प्रोवाइड करवानी पड़ेगी इमरजेंसी केसेस में. ओके, सो आफ्टर दिस 1996 लाइक ये चीजें जो है प्राइमरी हेल्थ सर्विसेज में इंक्लूड होने लग गई. सो नाउ जस्ट लुक एट दिस पिक्चर, इट इज द पिक्चर ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट. सो द सुप्रीम कोर्ट, it was established on 26 January 1950, and the day India became a republic. In this particular on this particular day, 26 January 1950, we implemented the Constitution of India, and on this very particular day India became a republic. So like its predecessor, the Federal Court of India, 1937 to 1949 में जो पहले सुप्रीम कोर्ट से पहले या जो इंडियन रिपब्लिक बना था उससे पहले जितना जो कोर्ट सिस्टम चलता था, 1937 से 1949 में जो फेडरल कोर्ट था वो चैम्बर ऑफ प्रिंसेस, हमारा जो पार्लियामेंट हाउस है ना, चैम्बर ऑफ प्रिंसेस में, सॉरी पार्लियामेंट हाउस में चैम्बर ऑफ प्रिंसेस है, वहां पे जो है ये सुप्रीम कोर्ट था. But it moved to its present building on Mathura Road in New Delhi, 1958. जो present आपका Supreme Court है आज की date में, ये 1958 में जो है locate हो चुका था, situated हो चुका था. Okay, so according to this, Supreme Court was established on 26 January 1950, and on this particular day India became republic, and in 1958. Supreme Court moved on Mathura Road in New Delhi. Okay, so class, this is all about today. Thank you so much for joining the class. Please go through this topic, read the topic very carefully, and in our next class we will discuss about the independence of judiciary. Okay, so read the chapter, and if you face any kind of problem, do ask me in my next class. Okay.